Michael Myers is dead.
There's a trip that's being planned by almost all the students in the school.
We could have a Halloween party, just the four of us. We could have a roaming orgy.
I love the way this man thinks.
A couple of the kids stay behind and decide to have their own little party.
That leaves a small handful of people back at the school during the actual date of Halloween.
Oh shoot, honey, someone say, can I call you back?
And LL's a security guard.
The parents have given me strict orders. Don't let the kids off the property.
Just sort of like this ominous feeling surrounding us.
He's back.
She's forced to confront the fact that Michael Myers is back and that Michael Myers is there at the school.
Michael!
There's an open gate, a car is running, and she could get in the car and drive away. Turns back to go back into the school where she knows he is and face him to the death.
Michael!
And what she ultimately chooses is that the life she would be leading outside those gates is the same life she'd be leading the last 20 years, which is no life at all, because she's dead. She's risking her life to save her soul. That is, in a horror movie, a profound moment, and it works like gangbusters. Okay, so these horror movies always end up a showdown between good and evil. But what exactly is evil, and how do the filmmakers create it? When we come back, the making of a monster named Michael Myers.
The Sci-fi Channel's Making of Halloween H20 is brought to you by Dimension Films.
Life feeling no pain. What if you went through life feeling nothing?
Be careful what you wish for. In a future where dreams become reality, mankind must deal with the consequences. Welcome to Paradox. Premieres Monday, August 17th at 10 p.m. Eastern, only on the Sci-Fi Channel.
He doesn't speak a word, and he walks like he's got a really bad rash. But he's great with a Ginsu knife. His name is Michael Myers, and he's the original modern horror monster.
Why is he like this? He's so irritable.
He's a really pissed off guy.
He's pretty.
You got a mean streak in you, buddy. He is the quintessential boogeyman.
He is that evil deep side that we're all afraid we have inside ourselves.
While he's terrifying, he's has this very innocent, creepy edge to him.
He can't show any compassion, can't show any normal human emotions. That makes him evil, because he doesn't have consequences to what he does.
It may have a human form, but it takes subhuman characteristics.
He seems to be killed off an awful lot.
Can't kill him.
I mean, the man lives through stabbings.
And reappears because he is ultimate evil.
I do believe that that's who this man is. Now, these days, dinosaurs, werewolves, and other assorted creatures are all digitally created. But Michael Myers has always been and continues to be the real thing.
That mask. It's human, but at the same time, totally featureless.
There's a very eerie, sort of haunting quality to it.
There's no emotion, there's no personality.
You can put whatever you want into that mask and into those eyes.
it allows you to superimpose what scares you the most on it.
In the first movie,
they got the mask from a costume shop, and it was
Captain Kirk's face,
you know, from Star Trek. So it's basically William Shatner, and they took that mask and spray painted it white. I wanted to return to the original mask. Of course, doesn't exist. There wasn't anybody taking care of it. The guy who's playing the shape would just stick it in his back pocket between takes.
Chris Durang, who plays Michael.
Action, please!
He's pretty brilliant. He really imbues this character with a great sense of menace and personality.
You know, he's a regular guy. He's a really nice guy, the guy who's playing Michael Myers.
Real nice, sweet guy.
He is a wonderful, warm, big teddy bear of a man.
Drink some pop with him, and then as soon as he puts the mask on, he's Michael Myers.
And there are times when I, you know, when I'd be talking to him and he'd have the mask on and I'm looking in his eyes and I'm trying to figure out, am I getting through to this monster?
That knife, man, it's huge. And it's a real knife.
The knife is real.
A real knife will motivate you.
What is the matter with him?
What's with him? A 19-inch knife like this, that's what's with him. He is slicing, dicing everything in his sight.
There was one point where I really sort of lost touch of reality and just, I was terrified. Josh, who plays Jamie's son, and I were trapped under the killer's poking his knife in through there. It was a real knife, and it was like this close, and I could feel it just swishing across my face.
She was really scared.
I mean, he's so close. I mean, he was like within inches of us with this knife.
They yelled cut, and I was still just hysterical, pressed up against the doors.
I defy anybody to tell me that woman's acting.
Michael Myers is a very cunning and creative guy when it comes to stalking his prey. And he does whatever is necessary to ensure that his murderous mission is going to be successful.
The unstoppable villain and a brave hero, that's me. They aren't the only tried and true elements to a classic horror film. Slashing and slicing requires style. When we return, a step-by-step lesson in how to carve up the perfect horror film.
Hi, sweetie. Hello.
Halloween.
It was incredibly innovative at the time.
It was sort of the granddaddy of a certain kind of thriller, horror, slasher genre.
One that set the tone for
all of the things that have become sort of standard now.
They've been ripped off so many times.
Everything from the music to the visuals
are really what Halloween started.
While comedies are all about timing and dramas depend on close-ups, the horror film has to have one thing, the element of surprise. What you don't expect can hurt you, but what you do expect can hurt a lot more.
What we're trying to do here is literally just scare people to death.
There are some accepted styles, things that help moody lighting.
All right, let's not anyone mess with me here. You've been suspended 5 times this year already for getting a little crazy with the snake, all right?
Low camera angles.
In horror, the camera's always coming down you from below.
Action, please!
Oh, good morning, Miss Kay. Thank you.
The Steadicam operator was used so much in this movie that there were long sequences where it felt like he was another cast member.
Oh, and I do trust him. I used to be
the wide-angle lenses, keeping the camera moving.
The camera is just right there in the middle of what's going on.
The camera moves and it's so silent.
You're choreographing what you're doing very much around this other person.
And then it sort of speeds up as the movie speeds up.
Once you hear action, it just all falls in place.
There's never a chance for you to become bored or distracted.
At that point, there's so much adrenaline running through your system.
It just keeps moving like a bat out of hell.
Building tension goes to the core of horror, and nothing signals evil intentions like gothic music tracks. Jaws has its signature sound, Psycho coined scary knife slash. For Halloween H2O, these four notes are enough to make the hairs on your neck stand at attention.
The Halloween theme is very memorable.
It gets you.
The minute it comes on in the film, you go, oh yes. Right back there.
It's chilling. I have it in mind when I'm shooting, actually.
And you can just feel it just like tingling down your spine that something really bad is gonna happen. Very simple, but very memorable.
You're so just caught up in the entire visceral experience of it.
That's the key with music.
The music is the screams on the roller coaster.
It's as important as the script, as important as the actors. You want to have that uneasiness.
Help! Oh! Damn it! Oh, Miss Tate, I'm so sorry. I didn't mean to make you jump.
Janet Leigh was the star of Psycho.
I brought the psycho element into the movie.
I know it's not my place. If I could be maternal for a moment.
Turns out she's Jamie Lee's mom, as everybody knows.
I had an opportunity to ask my mother to be a part of this movie.
I don't like to see you like this.
It's special that my mother would come onto our set and sort of tip her hat to the fans and to Psycho.
We've all had bad things happen to us. The trick is to concentrate on today, okay?
Thank you very much. I'll see you Monday.
It's a great cameo. It's scary, it's funny, it's poignant.
It was really cool, actually.
Getting the same car that she had driven, had been buried in Psycho, for her to drive away at the end of her last scene in Halloween.
Oh, Miss Tate, happy Halloween.
All of that together in a three-minute scene is really a great work.
Smart, sort of clever choice.
Hopefully some of the luck and the class of that project is going to imbue this one.
You do things in a big way.
Next, the cast and crew of Halloween reveal their most frightening moments on the set and their biggest fears in real life.
Need contact lenses?
Welcome back to the making of Halloween H2O. Michael Myers is evil. His ominous presence and his freaky mask are meant to bring out the worst fears on all of us.
If they frighten the bejesus out of a little kid sometime, I more power to them.
I think people like to be scared.
Yeah, I get scared of the movies.
Don't go in there!
But you know, I'm a different kind of person. Me personally, I laugh.
We We asked the cast and crew of Halloween, what's your biggest fear? What gives you the creeps in real life?
What do I fear most?
Not something I want to go into.
I'd say failure.
These interviews.
I've had like a few frightening experiences in my life that just scared the pants off of me.
Then there's nothing to fear but fear itself.
You watch Halloween H2O. That's what I fear.
See, I could be really kind of quirky and come up with something stupid and funny. Or I could tell you the truth.
Michael Myers, baby, that's my biggest fear.
My worst fear would be something to happen to my children.
I think that's the thing that most scares me, is to like look back and say, God, I wish I would have done this and rather than done it.
I guess waking up and being Ronnie, I mean, that would be a nasty situation to wake up and have to be this character right now and have to live my life like that and be running from Mike. That's a problem for me.
They say history repeats itself. Well, if I have anything to say about it, they're wrong. History just gets better with age. 2 decades ago, the first Halloween redefined the contemporary horror movie, and audiences haven't looked back since. Of course, looking back may not be a good idea because you never know who may be hiding around the corner. I'm Jamie Lee Curtis, and this has been The Making of Halloween H2.
Hooray for a child that makes it through, if there's any way, because the answer lies in you. They're laid to rest before, they've known just what to do. Their souls are lost because they could never find what this life.